Good evening. Welcome to St. Bartholomew, the Apostle Church. We gather today to celebrate the sacred liturgy for the 16th Sunday in Ordinary Time. I invite everyone to please stand and offer a welcome to one another. Please join in our entrance hymn, Lift High the Cross.
Lift high the cross, the love of Christ proclaim, till all the world adore his sacred name. Led on their way by this triumphant sign, the
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and the Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks.
Jesus.
glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. There is no God besides you who have the care of all, that you need show you have not unjustly condemned. For your might is the source of justice. Your mastery over all things makes you lenient to all. For you show your might when your perfection of your power is disbelieved. And in those who know you, you rebuke temerity. But though you are a master of might, you judge with clemency, and with much lenience you govern us. For power, whenever you will, attends you. And you taught your people by these deeds that those who are just must be kind. And you gave your children good ground for hope, that you would permit repentance for their sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Abounding in kindness to all who call upon you. Hearken, O Lord, to my prayer, and attend to the sound of my pleading. Lord, you are good and forgiving. All the nations you have made shall come and worship you, O Lord, and glorify your name. For you are great, and you do wondrous deeds. You alone are God. Lord, you are good and forgiving. You, O Lord, are God, merciful and gracious, slow to anger, abounding in kindness and fidelity. Turn toward me and have pity on me. Give your strength to your servant. Lord, you are good and
a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit comes to the aid of our weaknesses, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings, and the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes for the holy ones according to God's will. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to little ones the mysteries of the kingdom. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus proposed another parable to the crowd, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a man who sowed good seed in his field. While everyone was asleep, his enemy came and sowed weeds all through the wheat, and then went off. When the crop grew and bore fruit, the weeds appeared as well. The slaves of the householder came to him and said, 'Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where have the weeds come from?' He answered, 'An enemy has done this.' His slaves said to him, 'Do you want us to go and pull them up?' He replied, 'No. If you pull up the weeds, you might uproot the wheat along with them. Let them grow together until harvest. Then at harvest time, I will say to the harvesters, first collect the weeds and tie them in bundles for burning, but gather the wheat into my barn.' He proposed another parable to them. 'The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that a person took and sowed in a field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, yet when full grown, it is the largest of plants. It becomes a large bush, and the birds of the sky come and dwell in its branches.' He spoke to them another parable. 'The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed with 3 measures of wheat flour until the whole batch was leavened. All these things Jesus spoke to the crowds in parables. He spoke to them only in parables to fulfill what had been said through the prophet, 'I will open my mouth in parables. I will announce what has lain hidden from the foundation of the world.' Then, dismissing the crowds, he went into the house. His disciples approached him and said, 'Explain to us the parable of the weeds in the field.' He said in reply, 'He who sows good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world. The good seed, the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one, and the enemy who sows them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the harvesters are angels. Just as weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all who cause others to sin and all evildoers. They will throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Whoever has ears ought to hear.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Back in seminary, which I know wasn't too long ago, I remember learning about something that resonated with me back then, and something that continues to resonate with me even now. You know, oftentimes when we look out at the church, which we can also call the kingdom of God on earth, we might believe that the guardians, the laborers in the field that continue to grow the church and bring people into the life of the church are just priests and deacons, bishops, or religious sisters and brothers. But friends, that only makes up one portion. It only makes up one portion of the body of Christ. And don't get me wrong, it's an important part of the church, but there's an even larger part of the body of Christ. And that's you, the body of Christ, the largest part of the body of Christ. You whom we call the laity, all of the faithful who are not priests and religious. And the reality is that you make up most of the body of Christ, most of the church. So what did I learn in seminary that resonated deeply back then and resonates even now? That all of us, but in a very particular way, all of you, the lay faithful, are given a very special mission. You are called to be hidden leaven in the world. You are called to be hidden leaven in the world. You are called to be the leaven that creates the conditions for the kingdom of God to grow and continue in the world. Just as yeast makes bread, so are we to make God's kingdom, his reign of love and salvation present in the world. No matter how flat or tough or lumpy the dough of the world might be. That's all of our mission, but in a special way, that's your mission. So in a very simple manner, all of us are in the business of making bread. And the question is, are you and I making that bread in the world? The bread which is God's kingdom. Are you and I acting as hidden leaven in the world? In our gospel today, Jesus uses three parables. The parable of the wheat and the weeds, the parable of the mustard seed, and the parable of the hidden yeast. And perhaps we recall learning a bit about the wheat and the weeds, or the mustard seed, and its relation to building up God's kingdom in unexpected ways. But I believe Christ is desiring to teach us what it means to be hidden leaven in the world. In the shortest of the three parables today, we hear Jesus say, "The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed in 3 measures of wheat flour until the whole batch was leavened." It's a seemingly strange parable, just 1 sentence long, yet filled with one of the greatest and most subtle of Jesus's teaching. First, what is yeast? What does it do? Yeast is small. To the eye, very insignificant, almost invisible within flour. And I have to give kudos to Father Frank, because he gave me a little bit of his own active yeast. He's more of a baker than I am. But if you've used yeast before, you know how insignificant, how simple, how almost invisible to the eye it is. But if you've made bread before, you know how significant yeast actually is. Though insignificant next to the flour, it is the yeast that causes the dough to rise. In other words, it is the yeast, the hidden leaven, that has the power to transform and to elevate the wheat into something altogether new, into something altogether better than what it was before. So friends, what does it mean when Jesus says the kingdom of heaven is like yeast hidden within 3 measures of flour? Jesus is saying that we hold within us the potential to change the world from within. He is saying that we have the power to transform and to elevate what is dull and what is lifeless. We have, as the kingdom of God, though at times seemingly small and at times seemingly invisible to the world, the power to change it. And friends, I can't emphasize enough that this role to be leaven in the world is given especially to you. Why is that? Because you go to the places that we can't. You can be leaven in the places that we don't always reach as priests and deacons and bishops and religious. And what do I mean by that? By who you are as mothers and fathers, as children, as siblings, as workers with secular professions and occupations, as students. In the ordinary circumstances of your lives, you can proclaim the gospel. You can bring Jesus to the world. And just as leaven makes dough to rise, you too can make the kingdom of God rise on this earth. And so my hope is that this blows you away as much as it does me, that we're all in the business of making bread. Because you know, as a priest, I am called to consecrate simple bread into the body of Christ, to sanctify all those who come to this altar. But friends, you too are called to make bread by your lives, to sanctify the world by the way that you live, by the way you choose to seek what is good, and what is true, and what is beautiful. And perhaps right now you might be asking, how do I live out that mission to be hidden leaven in the world? It seems so difficult. Where do I start? Well, it's done by living our faith more than speaking it. And it's done by speaking our faith when it's necessary. It's by being joyful witnesses to what Christ has done in our lives. It's by bringing faith in our homes, into our workplaces, into our social circles. So, brothers and sisters, the question is, are we making bread? Are we living out our call to be hidden and transformative leaven in the world? The invitation to all of us today, especially you, the lay faithful, is to strive to be leaven. So do not be afraid to be that leaven, because it is then that God will use you, and it is then that you will see the transformation and growth in our homes, in our children, and in the world. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us please stand to profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven.
And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man.
For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in God's goodness and mercy, let us now offer our prayers for ourselves and all who are in need.
For the Church, that each of us may let the seeds of the gospel take root in our hearts and bring forth a harvest of justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, may they govern with concern for those who have no power or wealth, and consider their needs when developing policies and setting priorities. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are bound by hatred and resentment, that the Holy Spirit may cultivate forgiveness and understanding in their hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace, that God will bring an end to warfare in Ukraine, Sudan, Syria, Israel, and Palestine, protect the innocent from harm, and establish justice for all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer from the extreme heat, especially the elderly and those who work outside, may they be able to remain safe and find relief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they rise in the splendor of God's eternal kingdom. We remember especially Ellen Beth Miller, Javier Jimenez, Elsa Lamastra, and Carol Ann Bednar. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God who provides for all our needs, may we be inspired to always imitate your generosity and hospitality. Hear our prayers, both spoken and silent, and grant what we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Dawn of eternal day, all creation will rise to dance and sing the glory of the Lord. And on that day will justice triumph, on that day we'll all be free, free from want, free from fear, free to the day of the Lord, the sun will shine like the dawn of eternal day. All creation will rise to dance and sing the glory of the Lord. Then shall the nations throng together to the mountain of the Lord. They shall walk in the swords to plowshares, there will be an end to all.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the Lord, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty, we may benefit the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might to the praise of your manifold wisdom be manifest as the church. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you as with joy we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna.
Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Joseph our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Cannot end, for what God joins.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Send forth by God's blessing, our true faith confessing, the people of God from his dwelling take leave. God's sacrifice ended, all now be extended, the fruits of this mass in all hearts who believe. The seed of Christ's teaching our inner souls reaching shall blossom in action for God and for all. His grace shall incite us, his love shall unite us to further God's kingdom and answer his call. With praise and thanksgiving to God who is leaving the tasks of our everyday life we embrace, our faith ever sharing, in love ever caring, we claim as our neighbor all those of each race. One bread that has fed us, one light that has led us, unite us as one in his life that we share. Then may all the living with praise and thanksgiving give honor to Christ and his name that we bear.
Thank you.
They say partly, and then somebody that had to be
Listen, good problem.